So RT-PCR is the gold standard, undoubtedly. But the way you collect the sample, that is by brushing the back of your nose, that is your nasopharynx, as we call it, and then the tonsil pillars of your throat. In spite of all that, the considered accuracy of the test means your sample collection is anywhere around 70 to 75%. So that means a full 10, 20 to 25% can be missed in spite of the fact that the virus is there. But if the load is high enough, usually you'll pick it up. So the accuracy goes up as the load, viral load in the back of your throat is or nose is there. Second is the way it is actually in RT-PCR, there are two processes. One is the extraction phase, where you have a medium in which you extract the virus, and then you use the cytoflow to see how what the CT score is for that. For that CT score, different labs may have different, but the standard one is 0 to 40. The higher, or maybe even 50 to 60, it depends on what you're in. But if we say in our lab, if somebody is below 34, you start being suspicious. Above 35 means that is the, this is the dilution that the virus is not there. So if it is in the mid-range, you say weakly positive, and the lower it gets, the dilution, the stronger it is. So that's one thing, the measurement of the viral load will be indirectly determined by the score, CT score of your RT-PCR. Okay. Second is the fact that serology is the difference is that it only detects the first 3 days are blind. If it starts turning positive, and it's then you know that if it is positive, then you're positive. So the accuracy is the negative is the problem, not the positive. So you can miss it with serology, and the problem is the standardization of the kits. There are hundreds of types of kits that are available, and some have been found useless, some little useful, some very useful. So that's the other vagary. RT-PCR is usually accurate in its, if you get the standardized material or the test kit, you're okay. But the sample collection and the extraction are the two critical. So that's why what will happen is then you'll find many negatives which are positive, but sometimes they call positive if it is in the borderline or something, and then you don't know, and then you repeat it and it's negative. One thing I'll warn you about. People, what they do when they find out they are positive, they start gargling betadine, this and that. And if you collect the sample after that, you'll find that it's negative. So if you really want the true sample, do not gargle for 24 hours, or to not to kill the virus, because the betadine does kill some of it.